Good morning to you both. Congratulations on the news. Sir Richard, I'll start with you for this latest deal. Why Grove Collaborative?
Thank you. Well, we wanted to partner with an exceptional consumer products company, and Virgin's mission and platform, we believe, offered the perfect opportunity to, you know, bring the two teams together. Grove is a fantastic business. It's got massive, I think, future growth. It's got brilliant management led by Stu. And what it's doing is deeply aligned with Virgin's purpose and ethos. It's at the forefront of the growing demand for purpose-led home and personal care products. It's focused on a sustainable future with the ability to grow quickly, to innovate quickly, and it has access to millions of customers, and it's the leader in this space. So it has an ambitious goal of becoming plastic-free by 2025, which I think all of us would welcome, and that was one of the key things that got me involved. And it has tremendous scale opportunity. I mean, it represents only, I think, a fraction of the $180 billion market for home and personal care in the US. But there's enormous growth, I think, for international growth and in the US itself. I think it clearly has the opportunity to become, you know, the global brand. And we'll work with that team to build it, establish it as a world leader. Stu, I think, could tell you a bit more about the excellent work that he and his team have been doing.
Yeah, the plastic-free goal definitely got my attention as well, Stu. But first, before we get into that, how quickly is Grove actually growing?
So over the last 3 years, from 2018 to 2021, our CAGR is about 54% on the top line. But the way we look at this, as Sir Richard said, is Grove's purpose has always been to transform the consumer products category. You know, these are products that are in almost every home in the world. Hand soap, dish soap, laundry detergent, bath tissue, products that have a mixed track record in human health and a terrible track record in terms of their impact on the environment. And we believe that these products can be transformed to have a positive impact on our health and on the environment. And so if you look, as Richard said, at the market size here, then we've seen really strong growth to almost $400 million that we expect to do in 2021. But we think we are just getting started in tapping into growing consumer demand for conscientious product across these markets. And we're only in the US today, but I think the trends that we're talking about here, God willing, will impact this market globally.
Yeah, so Stu, how do you do that? Because I mean, in the near term, we've been hearing about the supply chain issues, the higher materials costs that so many companies, particularly in the consumer segment, are dealing with right now. Then when you start to talk about a goal like plastic free by 2025, how do you make those products and then keep them affordable and competitive versus everything else that's out there in the market?
Well, you've got it exactly right, that we have to produce products that perform as well as what consumers are used to, natural or conventional, that over-deliver from a sustainability perspective and are at a price point that's approachable to the vast majority of consumers. And we're proud that our product succeeds across the whole country, successful direct-to-consumer, and successfully launched in Target this year, really bringing a big tent to the sustainability message. And so as we look over the long term, and candidly, as we address all of the well-publicized supply chain issues, our focus really is on how do we over-deliver for the consumer every single day in terms of efficacy, in terms of product design and consumer centricity, and in terms of sustainability, so that we can continue to build the following millions of customers strong today, but I believe just in the very, very first inning of folks who are joining our journey to make more conscientious choices in this huge category that touches so many of us.